Good evening. My name is Nella Mupier, and I am the Director of Programs for Girl Be Heard. And it is my pleasure to, for the very last time this program year, welcome you to our performance, Staging the Revolution. Staging the Revolution is a result of months of exploring and defining individual and collective leadership, power and privilege, and arts and activism. This show is about taking leadership to the stage. It's about GirlBeHeard participants stepping into their light and amplifying the issues that move them. It's about sharing their vision with us, enrolling us in that vision, and calling us all to action. The after-school sites and participants that will be featured this evening are to be commended for their incredible work, not only because it's amazing, but because they committed to this journey over this entire year despite the challenges that we faced. GirlBeHeard participants, you are strong, you are brave, you are creative, you are resilient, you are courageous. Thank you for an amazing programming year. Congratulations to you all. You should be very proud. I also want to recognize our incredible teaching artists who have served as cheerleaders, as mentors, as coaches, friends, and guides to our participants. Make no mistake about it, we can attribute much of our success this year to you and your amazing efforts. You've had to wear so many new hats. You've had to take on many new roles just to be able to help us cross this finish line and celebrate the success of this year today. Thank you for pouring yourselves into this program, and thank you for an outstanding year. I would be remiss if I did not also shout out the entire GirlBeHeard team. Yes, thank you staff, from operations to comms to development to programs. Our team is led by our executive director, Chi Caetano. Thank you, Chi. And I especially want to shout out and spotlight the education team, Ashley and Kate, for keeping the entire unit lifted. You are appreciated, and we thank you tremendously. We, of course, have to also extend gratitude to our board and our associate board, our funders and our council members for making creative arts programming accessible and possible in New York City schools. And finally, you. Yes, you, everyone who's tuning in, everyone who has supported us through this entire year, everyone who stands in support of girls, young women, and gender nonconforming youth anywhere. Thank you for supporting us in our quest to create art, seek justice, and build leaders. Enjoy the show.
Hello, everyone, and welcome. My name is Ashley Zaragoza, and I'm the lead teaching artist and education program manager here at GirlBeHeard. I will also be your host this evening, and I am very excited to be presenting our after-school program's annual culminating end-of-year performance, Staging the Revolution at Home 2.0. That's right. This is our second virtual Staging the Revolution. Of course, due to the pandemic and wanting to ensure everyone's safety, we could not do this performance in person. But just because we've had to physically be confined, that does not mean that the creativity has had to be confined. The creativity in tonight's show is on like popcorn, which I hope you're enjoying while you watch. We've got some visual arts with voiceovers, some Zoom theater acting, and even a talk show. Yes, you heard me correctly. Tonight's show will also touch on themes from the second unit of our curriculum, including power and privilege, community, and arts and activism, in addition to specific social issues that our participants have been exploring with their teaching artists. So get excited and get ready, because the amazing participants in our middle school and high school programs have been working so hard in devising these pieces that they're sharing with you all today. Before we get the show started, I do have a few things to mention. One, please stick around for a few minutes after the last performance to complete an audience survey for today's show. Your feedback is super important to us. I also have to take the survey, so let's just do it together at the end of the show. It'll be super quick, I promise. I'd also like to take a moment to acknowledge our after-school sites that aren't a part of today's performance. So shout out to Huddy, led by their TA, Felicia George. Shout out to Humanities Prep, led by TA Dre Vargas, who has another site performing this evening. Shout out to Haran, led by co-TA team Marsha Gilden and Lisi Wedemeyer, who also has another site performing today. And shout out to Urban Assembly, led by Salome Igas. Congratulations to them for all of the incredible work they've done this year. I've had the pleasure of visiting each of these sites and seeing the amazing work the participants and their teaching artists have been doing. So today we celebrate all of you along with those who are performing today. And on that note, let's get started with the show. So for our first performance, we have the dynamic duo at Susan McKinney, which is led by teaching artist Dre Vargas. Dre prepared an intro that they'd like me to read, so I will. I have been able to watch Julia, a talented visual artist, and Zakira, a phenomenal writer, blossom into two collaborative performers. Though circumstances have made it so that I had to step in for Zakira's parts in the show, Julia and I wanted to give Zakira a huge shout out for her amazing writing, for always being vulnerable with us, and for making this piece happen while navigating so much right now. Julia and Zakira truly are a dynamic duo. Well, you know what? I believe it, and I was lucky enough to get to see it for myself. So with that being said, here is the dynamic duo at Susan McKinney. Give them some love, y'all.
I am healthy, I am wealthy, I am rich, I am that bitch. I am gonna go get that bag, and I am not gonna take your shit. I am protected, well respected, I'm a queen, I'm a dream. I do what I wanna do, and I'm who I wanna be. Cause I am me, that's why BT, yo man got his eye on me. But I DC, cause I'm fly as bees, that's pss, pss, pss. I hit streets, I drive no keys, that's screw, 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 don't lie on me.
Young Black Indigenous Brown Asian women,
members of the LGBTQ community, let me tell you something, and I want you to listen carefully.
Don't let others get in the way of the dreams you're going for or stop you from doing what you want, because at the end of the day, you are you. Your opinions and your dreams are the only things that matter when it comes to your life and decisions.
A lot of girls are going through things that they don't feel like the need to speak up about because others might judge them, but you shouldn't ever feel like you're the only one struggling in something or feel like an outcast because you do something different from others. We are all different and unique in our own way.
Don't ever let anyone push their expectations onto you, and don't ever feel like you are less than what you are. Know your worth. Show them that you deserve respect and you're not less than the next woman, race, gender next to you. If you don't feel comfortable in your own skin or body, be who makes you comfortable.
Don't be afraid to show who you truly are and what makes you happy, because your happiness comes first. Before anything else, your happiness and peace in your life comes first. Also, whatever you identify with, whether cisgender women, transgender women, or queer, your rights, happiness, life, and opinions matter. Don't feel you need to be someone you're not to please society. Keep fighting because you matter along with everything your ancestors fought for. Use people's judgments as motivation to get what you want. Even to become the bigger person, it won't be easy.
It's okay to be alone, but it is also important to find people that are going to respect your self-worth and support you in your journey.
The sky isn't the limit. Keep striving.
Don't feel like you're any less human because some men can make you feel weak or dumb because you can't do certain things that they can do. You don't need to prove anything to them.
The one power we do have is that we are girls. That's our power right there. We are smart, talented, anything you can think of. That's what we are. We don't need men's validation to see if we're doing something the proper way. We are already future leaders in the making. Future doctors, lawyers, entrepreneurs, anything you can imagine. This is the type of motivation message for the young women who feel let down. This is for the ones who feel like they can't do anything or accomplish anything in life, or even for the ones who need a little advice in their life. So if you're any one of those people, listen up and listen clearly when I say you should never give up or feel let up about anything, no matter how hard life is.
For those that might say, I feel like I'm down at my lowest and can't do this anymore, but I'm telling you, this is for a reason. So why, you may ask? It's because your loved ones and community see a lot of potential in you, and you don't want the negativity affecting you reaching your dreams.
But at the end of the day, sometimes you just have to learn how to motivate yourself and think about how what I do can impact my future and future generations of people like me. Forget the negativity. This is for me and my future and my community's future.
And yeah, don't get me wrong here. I know sometimes trying to achieve something that you really want so badly can be so hard at times. But honestly, speaking from experience, based on all the stuff that you went through, it can help motivate and strengthen you into accomplishing anything in life, no matter what it is.
Healing and learning from painful past experience can make you hungry for what you want in the future. And if you also know that you're fed up and tired of being in that pain and hurt situation, you would really want nothing, and I mean most definitely want nothing in this world to let you stop now, and especially because of how far you've come in life.
Because trust me when I say that I've been there, and many others have too. You're not alone. I've had people stab me in my back just because they weren't loyal or even jealous. Be aware of envious people that don't want you to succeed.
Protect your energy. So if somebody tells you that you can't do it, or if you would never get nowhere in life because of what you're going after towards your future, just think again and watch how far you become. You can become greatness. And once you become that greatness, it could be one of the most electrifying feelings in the world, because it's like at that moment, you finally realize, hey, I actually made it.
I've overcome every obstacle that was thrown at me, and I did it. I'm so proud to say that I did. And honestly, nobody in this world could stop me now. Not even the most meanest.
The most toughest person themselves can't stop me, because I know what I can handle and I know my own strength. So if anybody who's looking down on me wishes that I could fail, who are you to stop me now after all that I've overcome? Who are you to sit there and try to hit me with the most hurtful words ever, telling me that I should might as well quit or that this isn't all going to work out?
But how about instead of you judging me and my every move that I choose to make, you should go after what you want in life. How about you go after your future? Go do the things that you've always wanted to do instead of trying to hate on somebody else's life just because you're not happy with yours. Go get up out of that predicament that you don't want to be in. Go change your life for the better instead of trying to change or attack somebody else's life for the worst. But hey, like people always say,
it all starts with you. So
until you decide to make that first move stepping towards your future, you're just going to be stuck in the same spot, because you're not going to be expected to go anywhere else if you don't move your feet and make that first step.
But at the end of the day, you shouldn't let nobody take control of what you want to do and how you want to do certain things, because in the end, this is all going to be for you, and you should be happy and proud of your accomplishments.
Remember, you matter along with your opinions. Don't feel like you need to bring down other girls to make you feel better about yourself.
We are all beautiful and unique in our own way, just for you.
Change overnight.
But we gotta start somewhere, might as well go ahead start here. We done had a hell of a year, I'ma make it count why I'm here. God is the only man I fear. They training officers to kill us, then shooting protesters with these rubber bullets. They regular people, I know that they feel us. These scars too deep, they heal us. What happened to COVID? Nobody remember, it ain't making sense. I'm just here to vent, it happened to one of your people. I'm in the future with you. With you.
In the Future by Zakira Young. Setting: gas station, New York City at 7 a.m. Brandon has just arrived to work and is setting up for his shift. He is playing music and getting ready. He is now set up. His first customer comes in. Good morning.
Good morning.
Heather is shopping and gathering everything she needs. Ma'am, are you okay?
Yes, I am. I'm just looking for something.
Okay, just let me know if you need help with anything. After some moments, Heather finds what she needs and Malika walks in. Heather notices that Malika looks suspicious and gives eye motions to Brandon to keep an eye on him. Brandon keeps an eye on him the whole time. Malika is walking around very slowly, looking behind and forward often. He has a big coat. Malika finally decides to make a move and pulls out a gun and points it at Heather.
Don't move or I'll shoot.
Brandon runs behind the food station while Malika's back is turned. Malika holds Heather hostage and jumps over the counter where register is.
Open the register.
I don't work here. Why did you choose me? I really don't even work here.
Malika turns around and notices Brandon hiding. He throws Heather to the ground and grabs Brandon, brings Brandon to the register. She decides to go to the back.
Open the register.
Brandon opens the register without a thought.
Give me all the money and give me all the food you have.
Brandon packs the food quickly. Heather dials up London, the trauma-informed intervention specialist.
Can I have one large pizza?
You know this is a trauma-informed intervention specialist line, right?
I do know that.
Are you in danger? If yes, say, can I get a large Pepsi?
Can I get a large Pepsi?
Okay, how many guards are there?
Only one.
Okay, stay low and my team will be on their way. London's team gets to the gas station. Malika notices them outside and grabs Brandon and puts the gun to his head.
Don't come near me or I'll kill him.
Please don't kill me. I don't want to die. I have a mom and two sisters that I gotta take care of. The team notices Malachi's eyes are bloodshot red, and they see used needles and needle marks in his arm, so they didn't do anything too risky to put Brandon's life in danger. The team still tries to calm Malika down and convince him that he doesn't need to kill Brandon, and they will help him. Malika still isn't calm, so they call London to where they were at so she can talk to him. Malika lets London come in to speak to him. London doesn't get too close to him. London's talking to Malika.
You don't have to do this. We can get you help. Just put the gun down. We aren't here to hurt you, I promise. We are just here to help you.
You promised to get me help and not just throw me into a rehab center like everyone else has? I can actually trust you? Will you be the listening ear that I need? Won't turn your back on me?
Yes, I promise, but you have to let the gentleman go and please put the gun down. Please, I'm begging you, man.
Malika puts the gun down and lets Brandon go and quickly falls to his knees. London quickly grabs the gun and passes it to her team and gives Malika and hugs Malika and gives him the hug he needed for so long. London walks with Malika towards the door, but they suddenly stop.
I'm sorry for trying to rob your store and pulling out a gun on you.
Heather slowly crawls out from the bag and notices Malachi is not in handcuffs.
Why isn't he in handcuffs?
Not everyone deserves to be in cuffs. He needs help, mentally and physically. Throwing him in jail and turning our backs on him isn't gonna help him. It's gonna make him angry and he's gonna do this again, feeling like we failed him.
So he's not going to jail then?
No, he's not. Actually, Heather, what are you doing here?
I was looking for something.
Heather, everyone doesn't deserve to be thrown in jail. He needs help and a shoulder to cry on and a listening ear, which is what I'll give him. If you ever need anything, we're here for you, Malachi. And we will help you through anything if you need food or somewhere to sleep.
Thank you so much for everything.
Malachi and London leaves out the gas station. Till this day, Malachi has been 18 years clean.
And it's all love. I see a black woman in the street dancing happily.
Wow, please give them some love, y'all. Super carefree. And Zakira. Also, shout out to their TA Dre for stepping in so that Zakira's words could still be shared with us today. What a great start to our show this evening. Now, next, we have a performance coming to us from MS381, which is led by teaching artist Micaela Anaya. They're a small but mighty ensemble known as the Gryffindor Elderflower Duo. In their performance, The Snake and the Elderflower, we enter a world of magical creatures and explore what happens when power over becomes power with. I'm so ready to enter this magical world. So here is The Snake and the Elderflower by the Gryffindor Elderflower Duo at MS31. Let's show them some love, y'all.
The Snake and the Elderflower. Roz, the rattlesnake, watched as the elderflower glimmered in its cave in the distance. She needed the flower for its medicine because her twin brother Raoul was dying. Roz had come so far battling creatures big and small for the sake of saving her brother. Little did she know the hardest challenge was going to be getting past the elder guardian, Alexander.
Alex watched from the treetop. There was a shift in the energy tonight. He felt as if something was present. Alex was used to feeling different energies of the creatures of the forest, but this feeling was unusual. He felt as if something was passing through, but not something. Actually, someone. Keeping this in mind, he checked the moon. It was midnight in his dinner time. He swept the forest floor and found a delicious mouse. He decided that until he found the source of the strange presence, he would stand guard by the cave, because he knew something was going to happen.
The elderflower also felt a presence in the air. It was something different, like the being wasn't from the forest, but had made a long journey. The elderflower was the only one of its kind and had smelled many different creatures in its past, but this creature was different. It was a stranger. The elderflower knew it couldn't do much, so they decided to twirl with the hopes of sprouting seeds so they wouldn't be so alone.
Roz looked at her surroundings. She had been slithering to the cave, but then the owl appeared. Because Roz knew the owl had keen senses, she decided the best thing to do was rattle her tail and hide until the owl left the cave.
Alex was munching on his fifth mouse of the night and some fresh stream water near the tree he called home when he heard a noise coming from the bush from the far end of the stream and went to see what it might be. Alex didn't suspect much, but he wanted to make sure, remembering there was an unfamiliar presence in the air. Before he left, he made sure to place a trap by the flower, an invisible net made of spider webs, which could signal him if there was an intruder.
Roz saw the owl fly by and suddenly made her way to the cave. The cave was spacious, large enough for an elephant. She knew there would probably be booby traps, so she carefully slithered in, dodging the spikes that came down from the wall and barely missed the acid pool. but she didn't see the huge web that protected the flower until she was stuck. How lucky you didn't set off the alarms,
the elderflower said. What do you mean? Roz asked. The elderflower pointed their petals to the alarms at the edges of the net.
I saw you distract Alex and slither past,
the elderflower said. Roz looked at the flower, still processing how the flower was alive and could speak. The flower recognized the look and said,
What? Cat got your tongue?
The elderflower chuckled. No, sorry, I didn't realize you were alive, Roz responded.
Of course I'm alive,
the flower said.
How else would my magical powers work? Is there a reason you're here?
The elderflower asked. For healing, Roz replied.
Not many creatures come for my powers to save a loved one. Most would for their own gain or to look and feel younger,
the elderflower said. Roz was shocked. She hadn't known the elderflower could read minds. Roz looked down. Yeah, my brother isn't doing well. All the healers in town couldn't help him.
Is that the reason you came today?
The elderflower asked. The snake looked at the elderflower and said, Yes, that's the reason I came. My brother is ill, and you're the only thing that can help him.
Very well, then. We need to wait for the elder guardian,
the elderflower replied. But Roz didn't want to meet the owl and started struggling against the web, trying to untangle herself. She tripped the alarm.
Alex was munching on a 1 a.m. snack of almonds. When he heard the alarm, he flew to the cave. Alex hasn't seen an intruder in a long time and didn't know how to respond at first, but then remember his training, he snapped back to reality and grabbed the snake with his talons, yelling, What are you doing here? Are you here to steal the flower for your own gain? You have 5 seconds to answer me or I'll gobble you up. I'm still hungry and I haven't had snake in a while. Roz, terrified, responds,
No, I promise I mean no harm. I'm here for my brother. He's not well.
Yes, Alex, it's true. And I know your training means to protect me. But don't you think we need a new set of rules? Maybe more conversations and less intimidation? Roz and I talked, and I saw in her the truth in her mind. She means no harm, the elderflower said. Alex stopped and looked at the snake. She was terrified with tears in her eyes. He put her down and bowed. My apologies. The old flower's right. Our highest aim is to give healing to those who need it. It's been so long I could only think of guardianing when sharing is our true calling, Alex said, rising from his bow. Hello. My name is Alex, and I am the older guardian of this flower. Who are you? He said, composing himself.
I'm Roz, and my brother is very ill. He's not able to do much, so I'm getting the flower for him. I promise I don't need too much. Just a petal will do.
Alex looked at Roz. A noble creature such as yourself, using the elder flower for the greater good, deserves to use her powers, Alex said. In response, the elder flower dropped 3 petals. Blessings to your brother. Please come back soon. We need more heroes to help share my medicine, the elderflower said. Ross took the petals and said,
Thank you so much. I'll be sure to come back.
The elderflower said, You'll always be welcome as long as you use the powers for the greater good. Inside one of the petals is a seed. It's a miniature in me that will grow. It might be small, but it's mighty. Use its petals to give it to families in need. We know healing hurts are hard to find, so hopefully these will help. The best way to heal your brother is to make a soup with the best herbs. Do you have them? Alex said.
Yes, we do.
You must make sure the soup is hot and serve it at midnight. He should be good as long as he's still in this realm. Once he passed to the realm of the dead, nothing can bring him back, Alex said. Roz nodded, understanding, and asked the owl,
"Is there any way I can get back quickly?"
"My friend, the Luna Moth, can take you," Alex said. And as if summoned, a beautiful green and white moth appeared. Roz embraced the Elder Flower and Owl and hugged. She seats herself on the Luna Moth, rattling her tail in farewell to the Elder Flower and Alex as she soars high into the sky, ready to save her brother.
The end.
Yes, how cool was that? And what a creative way of exploring power through storytelling and magical creatures. I told y'all that the creativity was on like popcorn, all right? Beautiful work done by Athalia and her TA, Micaela at MS381. Let's keep the love going for them in the chat, y'all. Now, our next performance is coming to us from Brooklyn Prep, which is led by the teaching artist Adriana Hillas. And here's what she had to say about her group. The amazing trio at Brooklyn Prep, Kayla, Anaya, and Gabrielle, otherwise known as Bluettes, bring you pieces that explore the journeys three characters find themselves on in joining the Black Lives Matter movement. Whether through personal experience, social media, or through their art, they each find themselves joining, leading, and amplifying a Black Lives Matter march. I'm excited for you to see Kayla, Anaya, and Gabrielle's work, three wonderful artivists. Well, we're excited too, Adriana. With that being said, here is the work of the Bluettes from Brooklyn Prep. Give them some love, y'all.
Hello, my name is Gabrielle Kendall, and this is the story of my character, Victoria, based on real-life events that tragically affect too many people every day. I would also like to give a trigger warning that this story deals with police brutality and violence. Please do what you need for yourself. Thank you for listening. One Monday evening, Victoria's mom and dad were driving home with Victoria and her two little brothers, Alex and James. Victoria was having a lot of fun in the car. She was laughing with her brothers and listening to music while her parents were talking about the day they had and how good the food was because they had just left the restaurant. All of a sudden, Victoria nervously said,
"Is that a police car right behind us?"
When Victoria's parents saw this, they pulled over right away. Victoria, Alex, and James were terrified about what was going to happen. The policeman asked for ID and driver's license. Victoria's dad said, "Sir, why am I being pulled over?" The policeman was not having it and asked him to step out of the car. Victoria's dad didn't want to at first and refused. But then the policeman asked again and then he did step out. Victoria asked,
"Dad, is everything going to be okay?"
"Everything is fine," her dad said. The policeman told him not to move. Victoria's dad started to move around, and then Victoria's mom told him to go back. Then it happened in a flash. Victoria heard a loud bang and saw her father fall to the ground. Victoria yelled,
"Dad!"
Her mom got out of the car and started screaming,
"Why did you shoot my husband?"
Five years later, Victoria was starting to get educated about the harsh reality that we live in. Her brothers were too young to remember what happened to her dad. After realizing what happened to her dad, Victoria wanted to fight and try to end racism and police brutality so that no one had to experience what Victoria had to go through. Victoria felt strongly about this issue, and she was devastated to see how many families have to experience this. Victoria wants to end this so that no one should have to go through this because it's not fair. Moving forward, Victoria starts to go to a lot of protests to fight for Black Americans and to try to end police brutality and racism.
Breaking news! Another innocent Black man was killed by the police!
Oh my gosh! This is terrible! Guys, we need to find a way to get teens like us involved in this cause.
Why don't we use social media? There's a lot of people our
age. Great idea!
I really hope that this works.
Don't worry, it will.
Wow, it got so many likes.
We should invite our followers to come protest with us.
Join us as we protest police brutality.
Wow, there are so many people here.
No justice!
No peace!
Blue. Blue is a color that can sometimes symbolize an emotion. That emotion, characterized by blue, is always known as sadness. That metaphor that goes, "I'm feeling blue today," always stands for something with more of a gloomy tone. But what if I told you that color also symbolizes a more serene feeling as well? Blue can be known as calm, intelligent, strong. Blue to me means peace. The blue waves dance and move with grace and peace. The blue sky looks right back at me, smiling. Even the occasional blue moon that shows up late at night is associated with the growth of wisdom. I wish that people can display some of the characteristics of blue in themselves. The world has chanted, enough of that injustice, enough with the hate, enough with the war. We need to identify what we need to let go of and start holding onto peace, courage, and fellowship. Let's become more like our good friend, Blue.
Wow, I don't know if I want to snap or clap or snap and clap at the same time. What a powerful performance about such an important movement. And it's also so wonderful seeing the visual art by the participants. Amazing work to our Bluettes from Brooklyn Prep. Chat, give them some snaps and claps and all of the things. All of the things, the emojis, the hashtags, all of them. Give them some love. Now, I hate to say this, y'all, but we have reached our last performance of the evening. Don't be sad, though, because just like with the other groups, you're going to be blown away by the talent of these participants from MS88 in their performance, The Saturday Scoop. They were led by teaching artist Lisi Wedemeyer, who recorded an intro for their piece. Give this group lots of love. And here is Lisi introducing MS88.
Hi everybody, my name is Lisi Wedemeyer and I have the honor of being the teaching artist at MS88. Our students this year have done so much, created so many beautiful art pieces that it has been nearly impossible to cut them all down into just one event. I'm talking hours and hours of footage and creations surrounding all the themes we've talked about this year. We've covered stereotypes, power dynamics, identity, and all kinds of things in between. And I couldn't be more proud of the angle they chose for this show, where they took a very complicated topic like stereotypes and then tried to not only figure out what it meant to them, but also how they would explain it to a person much younger than them. It is my honor to introduce the Sister Spiders, starring.
Hi,
everybody. I'm Anaya.
Hi, everybody. I'm Isabella.
Hi, everyone. My name is Mia.
Hi, I'm Lucy.
Enjoy the show.
All right, we're going live in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
We're live from Olive Land Studios, and here's your host, Naya Scott.
Welcome. Welcome back to the show. I know it, you know it, the Saturday Scoop. I'm your host, Naya, and let's get started. Today, we will be talking about a very important topic, stereotypes. Stereotypes are assumptions and ideas that we hold about a group of people. For instance, today I went to the corner store before coming to the studio. I checked the weather and saw it was going to rain later, but I didn't bring my umbrella, silly me. So I stepped into the store and asked the person behind the cash register if I could buy an umbrella. He handed me a pink umbrella with a rose pattern. See, that's an example of a stereotype that he held about females liking pink. He thinks that because I'm a girl, I like pink. Today, we will be talking about identifying specific stereotypes and challenging them. So let's get straight into the show. Hey, Grandma, I have something I want to tell you about.
Yes, darling. What is it?
Well, you know how I was telling you that I tried out for the football team in my school?
You did what? I don't remember any such thing. What? What are you thinking, my darling?
Okay, well, anyway, I tried out and today they posted the results and I found out, Granny, that I got in!
What are you talking about, you silly girl? You're a girl, you can't play football. See, you can't even ride without using one of these pens with fluffs. And here, I'm going to give you some lip gloss. You're missing a spot right there.
No, Granny, no. You're not even listening to me. What's so bad with being a girl on a football team?
I don't even know. It's horrible. Here, let me... you here. I've got a candle in my little cave, you know. Yes, you don't remember the stories I've told you about when I tried to do something as a young girl.
Hey, Romhilda, shouldn't we turn our girl group into a band?
That's a great idea. We totally should. Let's go ask the manager.
Yes, girl, you totally should. And I mean, you're so good. I bet you should be our leader.
Oh, thanks. All right. Excuse me, Mr. Manager. So we were thinking, maybe we could, like, you know, turn our girl group into like a band, you know, and play music, and I could be the lead singer.
Let me stop you right there. No way, Romhilda. You're backup singers. You can't be a radio sensation. You can't handle it because you're girls.
You don't know what it's like. No one will ever let you do anything.
That's not true, Granny. I mean, look. So, look, I won this for most valuable player. I scored the most wins on our team.
You won?
Yeah, I won!
That can happen?
Yeah, of course!
I'm so proud of you, darling. That's incredible.
Thank you, Granny.
Here, let's go. I'll buy you some ice cream as a treat.
Girls are people too. We're not weak. We can do the same things that boys can do.
Thank you.
Wow, what is this place? I've never been here before.
It's the Diversity Diner. I heard it's good. I don't know.
Welcome, welcome. You've never been before. Oh, no, no. Welcome to the Diversity Diner. You've got to try today's special. Fried pierogies covered in very spicy seasonings and herbs. It's so good. It's from all parts of the world. But don't take my word for it.
How hot? I do not like spice. How hot? Because if so, I gotta go.
Hello, I'm Martha Gerard, and I'm reviewing Diversity Diner. Diversity Diner is a great way for you to eat your own special little meals, whatever they are. You want Sloppy Joes that have waffles for the buns? Diversity Diner's gotcha. You want a spaghetti taco that has pickle relish? Diversity Diner's got it. So what are you doing? Come on down. Delicious lox-flavored coffee that you so desire. Diversity Diner's got it all.
Diversity Diner, it's just right for you.
And if it's not, we'll make it.
Diversity Diner, the perfect food for you.
So come on down right now.
Welcome, welcome. So we're back on the Saturday Scoop. And today we have two really awesome guests. First we have, what's your name, darling?
Bianca.
Bianca. Okay, welcome Bianca to the show. So Bianca, I have to ask, how old are you?
15 years old.
15. Oh, that's a good age. So Bianca, 15 years old. What are some things that you genuinely care about?
I care about people being happy, and I also care about my family, and I care about the whole world.
One rule that you think is unfair, and do you think you can change it?
One rule that I think that is unfair is us girls not being able to wear specific things and guys being able to wear whatever they want. And I think that I could change it by telling everyone the truth or showing the truth.
Ooh, yes, I totally agree 100%. Have you ever been told that you can't do something because of something that makes you different from other people?
I have been told that I can't really draw as much because that is not real therapy. Because other people don't do that.
Oh wow, that's cruel. Art is for everyone. Well, Bianca, you've told us a lot about yourself. Now, what advice or what message would you give to other young girls like yourself?
I would say don't worry about what people think about you and keep trying to boost your self-esteem because that is something really important because that's the only way you'll be able to love anybody else if you can't love yourself.
Yes, girl. Love yourself and then you can love others. So thanks so much for joining us, Bianca, on the Saturday Scoop. Next, we have our second guest, 5-year-old Maya, and she's going to come onto the show and tell us a bit about herself.
I'm 6.
Oh, I'm so sorry, darling. 6-year-old Maya. Hi, Maya. Maya, 6 years old. What are some things that you care about?
I really like spending time with my friends, and I like spending time with my sister, my older sister. Ooh. Pink. I like pink. Yeah.
Pink is a very nice color, Maya. So what is a rule that you think is unfair, and how would you change it?
I guess telling people that it's not fair, and that we can play whatever we want to play.
So true, so true.
Plus, like my friend Alex, he wants to play with my dolls, and I want to play with his trucks, but they won't let us. It's not fair.
Has anyone ever told you you should or should not do something, but you decided to do it or not do it anyway?
Well, people always tell me that because I'm a girl, I should like pink. And I do. I actually like pink. But then I go home and my mom tells me that I shouldn't just like pink because people tell me to like pink. But I tried to tell her that I like pink because I like pink and not because they tell me to like pink because I'm a girl, and it's really confusing. I don't like it.
Well, my advice to you is to just stick with what you like because you like it, not from the influence of other people, like your mom said. So, have you ever been told you can't do something because of something that makes you different from others?
I really like JoJo Siwa, a girl in my class, and she's really pretty, and I wanted to... But they said I couldn't. Yeah, I'm sick.
Oh no!
What are you looking at?
Are you alright, Maya? Advice would you give to someone, other girls your age or older than you?
If you like cars, get the car. If you don't like dollies, don't play with a dolly because they make you. And if you do like dollies, it's not because they tell you to like them.
Yes, thank you, Maya. Those are some great words of advice, and I'm sure many girls out there are going to follow your word and not play with dolls if they don't want to. So thanks so much for joining us on the show, Maya. Bye. You will be following along with me, and I'll show you how to make a sundae and how sundaes can represent parts of our identity. I will explore my own identity, and you can follow along. So first things foremost, I have vanilla ice cream here. Vanilla ice cream represents a part of my identity because I eat it a lot, and my family, everyone loves vanilla ice cream, so typically in family gatherings, we eat a lot of vanilla ice cream. It's one scoop. Another scoop. And third scoop. Yay. The second thing I have with me are some tasty fruits. I personally like berries, and my preference would be blackberries and blueberries. In my community, they're very fresh locally, and they also taste really good. So I will be adding blackberries and blueberries. Another reason why I chose these fruits are because I personally like a lot of tart fruits, such as lemons, blackberries, blueberries, so this was very fitting. I also have chocolate syrup, and I chose this not because I like it a lot, even though it's good, but just because I grew up eating it a lot. Whenever I have ice cream, I'm just used to having chocolate, whether it be chocolate ice cream or chocolate syrup. The last thing I have is the finishing touch, the cherry. You cannot have a sundae without a cherry. But also, cherries are part of my identity, and that's because cherries are one of my favorite fruits. So here's my finished product. Let's try it. Mmm. Yum. Thank you so much for making a delicious sundae with me today. And I hope that not only did you learn more about me, but that you'll learn more about yourself than doing this product or this project. Thank you so much, and see you next time. All of these different topics represent parts of our identity, character, and personality. What about people with different sprinkles or syrup? Famous from their Unplugged performance in January 2021, let's talk with the Sister Spiders, who will teach us how we can be supportive of others. How can we be allies?
Being an ally means being willing to act with and for others, or to be a good inspiration for someone. Be a good example.
Be open and supportive, and be there for anyone who might.
Take in everyone's differences and keep them in mind while also treating them like you would anyone else. Educate yourself on how you can support people who are different than you.
Normalize having conversations about difficult subjects, such as race, homophobia, transphobia, ableism, and human rights.
Be open to being wrong.
If you hear someone being told that they're not actually whatever sexuality or gender that they identify with, that it's just a phase, you can step up and speak out to whoever's saying that, because finding who you are is hard enough without other people inflicting their opinions on you.
Call people by their correct pronouns.
There are no us and them problems. We are humans and should treat each other like family.
On the stereo, no matter what they say, they can't tell you who you are. Stereotypes are not okay. You can be who you wanna be, who you truly are. You are you and you are free. Now go and be a star.
Yes, for the Sisters Fighters of MS88 and the Saturday Scoop. I'd like to start the petition to get this show on television, so please let me know in the chat if you're signing, and also let the participants know how amazing they did. Really awesome work, y'all. Well, that is it for tonight's show, everyone. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please click the link in the chat or the Q&A for the audience survey. Again, it's super short, and I'll be taking it too, I promise. And before we go away, I do want to thank and congratulate all of our amazing participants for sharing their work with us today. I want to thank their incredible teaching artists for leading them with compassion and grace. I also want to thank the team behind the scenes that helped make today's performance possible. So thank you, Olivia. Thank you, Kate. Thank you, Nella. Thank you, Kelsey. Thank you to the Girl Be Heard staff. Thank you to our site contacts and the city council members who fund these programs. And thank you again to all of you for watching at home. If you'd like to stay connected with us, visit our website, girlbeheard.org, where you can sign up for our newsletter, purchase some GBH swag, learn about our upcoming programs like Girl Be Exploring Summer Camps, and also donate if you would like to. Have a great night, everyone, and a great weekend. Do that survey. All right, I'm gonna do it too. Okay, bye, everyone.
I do my head toss, check my nails. Baby, how you feeling?
Feeling good as
hell. Head toss, check my nails. Baby, how you feeling?
Feeling good as hell.
Gone, dust your shoulders off. Keep it moving, yes, Lord. Trying to get some new shit in there. Swimwear, going to the pool shit. Come now, come dry your eyes. You know you a star, you can touch the sky. I know that it's hard, but you have to try. If you need advice, let me simplify. If he don't love you anymore, just walk your fine ass out the door. I do my hair. Change your life, you can have it all, no sacrifice. I know we did you wrong, we can make it right. So go and let it all hang out tonight, cause we don't.